is to present this body unto the Lord, as it were, as a living sacrifice. How can we do that? A lot of times we think, well, if I just attend service on Sunday morning, then I'm doing all the religious worship or service to the Lord that is really required. Or maybe if I come Sunday evening, or maybe on a midweek gathering or service. But what is the Lord asking of us? I think about the totality of a burnt offering in the Old Testament. When the offering was given, it was given in total. It was given completely. I believe this is what God is asking of us, that we would present our bodies unto the Lord as if someone in the Old Testament were presenting a sacrifice unto the priest. Holy, acceptable, submitted for examination so that the Lord could put his finger on this area or that area, and then to offer us, as it were, to offer our lives in a different metaphor, to give us marching orders, to give us something to do for him. Oftentimes we wondered, what is pure religion in God's eyes? What kind of worship is God looking for? Is he looking for those that would spend many, many hours in prayer? Many, many hours in study? Maybe many, many hours just spending time in worship? And perhaps God has called some of us to do those things, or all of us to do those things in some capacity or another. But there are some areas that I believe God is very clear on in what he is looking for when it comes to pure religion. In James chapter 2, we find a very interesting passage. James is writing and he says, pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this: to visit the fatherless and the widows in their affliction, and to keep himself unspotted of the world. You see the consistency there. You have this presenting of ourself, as it were, to visit the fatherless. That's with your body. That's something you can do. And the widows, in their affliction, in their sufferings. There are many, many dear saints of God that come to mind that have gotten older, that are elderly, that are sitting someplace tonight. Many of them think God has forgotten them, or they're wondering why the church may have forgotten them. They still love the Lord, but they need someone to come and to reassure them that God still loves them. Many of them have served God 30, 40, and 50 years. And now they don't even as much as have an opportunity to get out of their room, to get out of a building, and to go do the very thing that they did, expressing their faith all of their life. Children are much the same way. Many children tonight are locked up in alcoholic homes, homes where the parents are drug addicts. And God's eye is upon them, and he is concerned about them, very concerned. And in both cases that I mention, there are individuals that are faithful to go out and visit the fatherless and the widows, and to do what they can to share the love of Christ with them, to do the very things that Jesus himself would be doing, I believe, if he were here on earth.